Right, you lot, welcome back to the channel. Now, as you can see by today's title, this is going to be a full, real 24 hours day in the life of a newborn baby. Me and my girlfriend Erin have decided to do this and keep it literally as real as possible and try and film as much in 24 hours as possible to give you guys a real insight as to what it's like to be parents. So our baby Rome is 9 weeks, coming up to 10 weeks old, but he was 6 weeks prem, as a lot of you guys know. So I thought I'd start this off this evening. So it's currently, okay, it's just gone midnight. It is 11 minutes past 12. Erin and Rome are in bed. I'm gonna go show you in a sec, but I'm starting this in Rome's nursery because I thought I'd start with the evening and the night shift stuff, then into the daytime. And also I feel like starting it with this is probably the most realistic part and the thing that parents struggle the most with about having a baby, well, personally anyway, is the night feeds and stuff like that, and it's waking yourself up for the night and all that sort of stuff. So anyway, there's still half of you guys watching this that haven't subscribed to the channel, so please go down below, tap that subscribe button. It's free to do. All you've got to do is have a YouTube account and it helps us out massively, and also you won't regret it because when we get to 500,000 subscribers, there's going to be a massive giveaway. So if you want to be part of it, you've got to subscribe now and get in early. Anyway, Rome has had his jabs today, his first lot of jabs, his 8 week jabs, I believe it is. So he's had a medicine and then he had two jabs, one in each leg earlier at about 2 p.m. And obviously, like I said, it's just gone midnight. He had another lot of cow pole at about 10:30. So about 2:30-ish, he can have another lot. So he's about halfway through the dose of cow pole. But he has been quite a bit sad today, but we don't know if it's fully just a jab because he's not had a high temperature, which they said is potluck, really. Some babies will get it, some babies won't. He hasn't had a temperature so far, so that's all good. But we feel like he's crying a little bit more, and maybe that is just because of the jabs, you know, and especially when the cow pole's wearing off. Anyway, my point is he's been a little bit more sad today, bless him. So we've just been giving him extra cuddles, and obviously you don't have your jabs all the time, so what I'm gonna say is we might not get a lot of sleep tonight. He might be good, I don't know. Most of the day throughout the week he does 3 hour stretches, so let's say we go to bed at midnight and he's just fed, he'll wake up at 3, he'll wake up at 6, he'll wake up at 9. But anyway, I'm gonna go into the bedroom now. We have been on the top floor, which is where the spare room is now for most of his life. That's where we've been sleeping, but we've actually moved back down into here now, which is our actual bedroom. Just a bit of a mess right now. Completely real, guys, told you. We've got our little sterilizer put up here for the night. So this is what we do at the minute. We have our little newbies for the sterilized water. And then this is our little feeding station. So I've got another 4 bottles downstairs in the electric sterilizer, just so we've got extras. These are actually really helpful. We measure out our formula into here. So let's say he has 90 mil. I'll put 3 scoops in there. And then all I have to do, or I say all I, we both do the shifts. So all we have to do is take this off. That's it to be on there. So then you literally, you take this lid off and then you just pour this straight in. And then obviously when that's like, when that one's done, you can just take it off or refill it or whatever you want to do. But it's really, really helpful. And obviously we have this for our changer bag as well. But anyway, kettle's there. We have it right here. So we don't have to go down to the kitchen. Literally, we wake up. We have the station here, pot of formula if we need to top up, and obviously all of it is clean bottles. So this is us at the minute. We have the little white noise, which we're going to turn down just for the purpose of this. But I actually loved it at first. It was helping me sleep, but now it's just like, oh my God, it couldn't go off any quicker. Normally we have this red as well because it promotes deep sleep apparently. But we've got this on just for a minute while we're chilling. But he obviously has these little newborn noises, doesn't he? But I don't know, we feel like he's just being a bit more sad with his jabs, don't we? Yeah, but then he's also been struggling to poo.
Yeah, trying to poo. It's a mixture of bites I'll be like feeding him a bottle and then he'll start crying randomly, and he never does that.
So we feel like that's the jabs.
He'll only cry if he's hungry, and once he's got a bottle in, he stops crying. So we know he's been a little bit underwhelmed.
That bit's the jabs part, isn't it? But then he's also still like struggling to poo. He hasn't pooed today, so we're just looking at holidays right now, because why not? So anyway, yeah, this is the next to me that we've got. He was in his Moses, like in here, because it was like, this is way too big for him, but he's grown a lot more now. He's probably like 7.5 pounds nearly. Well, he was just about 7 pounds the other day, but Erin thinks he's had a massive growth spurt. So in this video, in the morning, we're gonna get him weighed. What's your guess now? I reckon 7 pounds 6.
7.8. He's in. Think how much he's been drinking, Brandon.
He has been drinking a lot, snacking quite a lot.
One can of Coke to keep him going through the night. We've had a rough couple of nights with him.
Yeah, he's last 2 nights he's been up quite a lot through the night. But then like last night, this morning, what am I talking about? He woke up at 8. He never goes down for another 3 hour stretch at 8, does he? That's his wake period in the morning.
He's
8/9. But anyway, this morning he did, because he had a rough night, I think. But he woke up at 8, everyone was shattered, so I took him upstairs.
And we put him in the bed, he sleeps. When I said put him in the bed, I meaning like he sleeps, we're awake.
Yeah, not like us all asleep with him in the bed. But I took him upstairs this morning and let Erin sleep, and he slept With me, as in I was awake, but he was asleep for 3 hours.
I didn't even hear you go upstairs, I was that tired.
I was like, I'm just going to go up there.
I think Brandon didn't even want to pick his battles with me.
No, I just went upstairs.
Yeah, you was like, I'm not even going
to go. Erin was up every hour from like midnight till 4, so she was pretty tired. Yeah. So it got to 8 and I was like, do you know what? I'll go upstairs. I was awake, funny enough, for the whole time. I was just sat at my desk. I was like, right, what do I do? Do you reckon I could get away with showering? Do you reckon I edit for a bit? Do I do work? Do I play PS5? I was editing. No, I was awake the whole time, obviously. But like,
is it hot in here?
It doesn't seem too hot. You say that, the radiator, I did say it was boiling. Look at my little Romy boy. Oh, bless him. He's getting so much bigger. Oh, he's getting so chunky.
Bless him, he's so good.
Ernie loves the attention now, look. He's like, don't forget about me. So this is us basically until, I mean, we've already done this scenario once tonight about half an hour ago, and he settles perfectly on Erin, and then we put him back, and what did he do?
He settled for a little bit.
No, I said he settled for half an hour, went to put him back in,
and then,
woke up, which he never normally does.
Feel your warmth, though. Mm. I think that's the problem.
And your heartbeat and all sorts. So God knows what attempt.
He is a lot better when we put something in there that smells of us. Like, I put like our t-shirt in there wrapped around like a cot sheet basically, and he sleeps a lot better. And like, we used to have these hearts that we had in the NICU. Mm.
The scent markers.
Yeah.
It's just a gamble whether we put him back in now and he risks waking up.
He will wake up.
Because I don't think we can go to sleep yet, because he's not gonna sell. Here we go, we've transferred him. Erin's just quickly gone upstairs to get ready to come back to bed. So she's moved him to the little elephant so fast. Oh, if you have a baby, you'll know exactly them noises. It's like the nervous thing of, is he going to wake up? Or is he just making noises and he's going to go back to sleep? Please, stay asleep. I mean, even if he was settled there, we'd have to move him to his bed anyway. Probably wake up in between. You are. It's because you're drinking Coca-Cola, mate. What do you expect?
Yeah, I want to be wide awake because... he needs his mummy.
Oh, I saw that. He's so beautiful. We're biased, but he's beautiful. It's time for a nappy change.
I don't want to do it and disturb him.
Oh, I know, but he's got a really heavy nappy.
It's the worst thing about having a... Well, it's not the worst thing about having a baby. Is when they're all sleepy and during the night, and then you've got to change their nappy.
Oh, no. You're so cute, baby boy. Yeah, he's not really up for this milk, but I feel like he might have it once his nappy's changed. His nappy's off and he's not moaning. This is really unusual. He does this, like, very rarely. I feel like a zombie. Oh gosh, right. The night time just feels like a blur. Every time I wake up, it feels like a blur. It's 8:51 right now. Roman's downstairs with Erin. Oh God. This just happened this morning. Whenever I blink, my right eyelid, the bottom one, hurts. I think I've got a sty coming. Hate it. I mean, it's from lack of sleep, but it's painful. Anyway, I've come upstairs to get ready because the first thing this morning we've got to do, what I've got to do, is take Ernie to get his groom done. He's due his little haircut. If you don't know who Ernie is, it's my dog. He's got a haircut in an hour, so I need to go and get ready in the shower before I go and take him to his groom. After his groom, I'm going to come back and then we're actually going to go to the clinic with baby Rome. Got to give a breast pump back, but we're also going to get him weighed, like I said yesterday. So I'm really interested to see how much he's going to weigh, because Erin feels like he's had a big growth spurt in the last like week. So it could be really interesting. I mean, he was literally £6.15. Could argue he was £7, £7.01 on his last weight, which was last week. I can't remember what day it was though. Regardless, I feel shattered. I'm not gonna lie, I just want to put my head on a pillow and just crash out for like the whole day. But this is the realistic thing of being a parent. It wasn't too bad in the night. Well, I fell asleep from 2 till 7, then I probably fell asleep half 7 till 7:15 So I had 5 and a bit hours, which is actually all right, to be fair, all things considered. He had a little bit of sick in the bed, so I think he was sick with Erin, but we'll ask Erin when she's awake properly. Time for me to shower.
Babies, come on in.
Oh, good boy.
Oh, right. I've had my shower.
You want to go wee wee's boy?
Oh, hello. You've got your hair cut in a minute. We're going to go then and get in the car.
Oh, God, that's cold.
Go throw wee wee's in.
He's like, no, this is too cold.
He's like, nope.
He's got a straight back upstairs. He's like, I'm going back to bed. Well, guess what? He's not.
He's coming. He's getting his hair cut in me.
Just take my tablet quick and my vitamin D's. Best things ever, these vitamin D's. And I'm not being paid to say this either, but I got these when I worked with a company called iHerb, if you guys remember. And honestly, I take these every day in the winter. They're so good.
Guys, we're in the car. We're not that icy, but it's absolutely freezing. I mean, I had this in my car from yesterday, so Ernie's on the little car washing towel, car drying towel. Oh, he's probably so cold. Oh, baby boy. Anyway, I'm gonna go get his haircut, or his groom, whatever you wanna call it.
Right, we've come to next down the road because there's so much traffic dropping Ernie off that I've not gone all the way home because it's just good. I'll get home and I'll have to come straight back out to get him. So I'm just going to linger around the area while Erin gets a little bit more sleep at home. So yeah, I'm going to go into next. There's Costa in there. I'm just going to go and chill. And then when we get back, like I said, we're going to the clinic. So comment down below, right? Pause it and don't cheat. Comment down below what you think Roma's going to weigh today. Bearing in mind last week he was 7 pounds basically on the dot. Let us know what you think. I'm going to go 7-7. 7-7. Even though how cold it's been in England, right, recently, I'm still so stupid. And I keep going out in t-shirts. This is the first day, I think, this winter I've actually gone out with a t-shirt under my hoodie and wore a hoodie. Honestly, I've been awful with it. Don't know why. I know it's cold as well. I just choose not to wear a hoodie, but nice and warm today.
I've gone for a ham and cheese. Was it ham and cheese? Yeah, ham and cheese with mustard, but it's got a crispy cheese on the top. Looks banging. And then a little small hot chocolate. Just a little breakfast date for one in Costa Coffee. Here's the boy. Oh, shake all that hair off in my car. Lovely jubbly. I just took his harness off so I can show you his whole haircut. Oh, you look so cute, boy. You want to go see mummy? Right, anyway, we're going to get home, guys. Get back to the baby and get on with the day.
So guys, we're in the car now. We literally rushed out the door. I mean, it is so hard getting out the house with a baby.
That was pretty smooth.
It's like a whole new level of skill. I've got a headache though. My eyes are burning. Hello, look how happy he is, guys. Hi, baby. Oh, look at his little face. Gonna go and see Auntie Nance. She's not seen you in ages. So yeah, she hasn't seen him since Boxing Day. So we're literally just gonna pop to her clinic and drop the pump back. So yeah, got him ready. I actually managed to get myself ready while he was asleep. I say get myself ready. I literally just shoved my hair up with a load of hairspray and chucked on a tracksuit. So that is the story of my life. He always looks lovely, best dressed, and I always look like I'm a
gentleman. What's he wearing?
Backwards. He's got his teddy outfit on. Obviously, we had a bit of a rough night. One, I think he felt a bit poorly from his jabs, but also he was trying to poo like mad, and I sleep next to him. Brandon doesn't hear him until he wakes up for his shift, and he had me up the whole night.
I must have just blanked it out.
Yeah, he was up all night like straining to go to the toilet, and then every time I got up to look to see if he was awake, he wasn't. He was asleep, so he was doing it in his sleep, and it just kept me up because it just kept waking me up. He was so loud. Like,
so he wasn't demanding you like in his arms or
no, what? Like he was just really shoving me to go to the toilet. Then he would like cry, but like I'd look and he would still be asleep, like his had his eyes shut. And then he woke up at 5 a.m. for a feed. So I fed him that, and then he woke up at 7 for Brandon. So yeah, overall it wasn't horrendous. Like he was asleep, but he was just waking me up, so you could say that's my fault. And then I had to change his nappy as well because he eventually did a poo, and apparently Brandon didn't hear any of that because he literally screams and cries.
All I remember in my head is falling asleep from 2 till 7. Don't remember waking up.
Right, we're back. It was chaotic. The fire alarm went off when we were weighing him, so we had to get out of there. But luckily, we got it looked. We got his tongue checked for tongue tie. He's obviously feeding absolutely fine, and they say as long as he's feeding, but potentially, and that could be why he's struggling to poo more as well, because the tongue links to the tension of going for a poo. But anyway, we're back. We went to Costa drive-thru quick so Erin could get this fajita chicken wrap thing and a sort of caramel frostino frappe. Okay. And then I got this new thing. Well, I don't know, is it new or is it just new to me? Apple and rhubarb refresher. It's actually quite nice, to be fair. So yeah, I told him all to comment earlier.
Comment down below your final guess of his weight. I thought he was going to be a little bit more on 8 pounds.
No, that was very wishful. That would have been a pound in a week. Well, drum roll, please. £7.06. Woohoo! I actually said £7.06 and then I changed to £7.07, but I'll take that. I'm always spot on. Last guess, I was spot on, mate. Erin's just tucking away, guys. Sorry. So, yeah. Romy boy's asleep, so we're just gonna enjoy the time.
Dogs will be back soon.
Yeah, dogs are out on a little group walk with their friends. Yeah, basically in this time, what do we do? Like, we just eat if we can, watch a bit of TV, sometimes sleep and catch up if we need to. What else do we do? Do some filming if we need to do some filming. Sometimes I play a bit of FIFA or a bit of COD. Editing. You drunk that rather quick. Don't drink like that. That is so annoying.
And you have to drink a glass straw.
You're just a freak.
I burnt myself in the oven yesterday.
Anything else? So, yeah, there's nothing really else for us to do. You know, it's just sort of random. I know what you're going to do. Watch TV.
I'm getting my nails done at 4:30.
It's 1 o'clock right now.
Got some tidying up to do. If Brandon will let me do some tidying.
Yeah, crack on. He's asleep. Make the most of it.
Also, my mum for Christmas got us a new dining room table.
I would show you, but the address is showing.
But we
need to get rid of our
other
one.
We haven't sold our other one yet, so I don't know what we're going to do about that.
Baby boy, is he sleepy head? Just transferred him, but he's not quite settled. He's okay, boy.
I think he's asleep. He's like active sleeping. He hates the transfer.
Yeah. He looks so comfy. I want to sleep in a sleepy head with a blanket on it.
He's never unsupervised in that, by the way.
Yeah, we're always watching him, don't worry.
Let's put a bit of white noise on, ready?
Oh, wow, Mum. Hey, yay, nice outfit. He's okay. He's okay, boy. Look how long he looks now. Oh, he's showing us your titsies.
It's feed time.
Is it Milky's time?
Oh, Baba. What's the matter? Mummy making you a bottle. Mummy's making you a bottle, okay? Oh, he's hungry. He's probably still feeling a little bit grotty from your jabs, aren't you?
Romy boy's hungry.
I'm tired. Nice to meet you.
Oh, shut up. He literally wakes up and within 30 seconds he's crying. It gives us a bite.
Please hurry up.
30 seconds to make his bottles. At the minute,
hungry. He's
having 90ml bottles. I did up it to, is it 4 ounces at the
yeah,
top?
Went to one
I did off it up it to 4 ounces, but he doesn't tolerate it very well. He just throws it all straight back up.
He'd do about 100, fine.
Yeah, so
maybe
we went back down to 90. But like, he's gaining weight really well. So, you know, sometimes he doesn't even finish a 90ml bottle. He's a snacker. Oh, I just love him so much.
He's so cute, mate.
I've never loved anything quite like him. But yeah, the Dr. Brown's bottles are really good, by the way. His wind is really good. Like, he gets his wind up so well. Like, sometimes he doesn't even need help. He just does it himself.
I always say this to Erin. Whenever I hold him, I get tired. It releases a hormone.
Yeah. Yeah, the Dr. Brown's bottles are really good. They've got the anti-colic thing down the middle. He's falling asleep. He does this a lot. He falls asleep on the bottle.
No falling asleep. You want to drink
the
milk?
He is such a sleepy baby. Obviously, he's a prem baby, so that's obviously why. So, yeah, he's going to have his milkies, and then he might go back to sleep, or he might have a little wake window. Doggies are back. Ernie's eating his dinner. He had a groom this morning and then he was muddy from his walk, so I've just given him a little wash. Peppa's there, darling. Hello, my girl. Anyway, I'm gonna go and finish watching these cinders and then I'm gonna sort the house out. You need to sort your dirty trains out. And Romy's having a little nap with his dad.
Right, I'm up on the top floor now. To be honest, this floor needs a tidy. This is real life. There's no point me tidying this and then filming and being, you know, fake. This is the current situation. I mean, we was sleeping up here and Rome's next to me was here. We've decided to move downstairs because this bed's a double and downstairs is a king. And this also creaks. So every time we get in that bed to settle him, it just creaks when we get back in. Anyway, if you're not new to the channel, you'll know that this is the spare room now. It's more or less my room, let's be honest. Well, we technically have got half and half, but then my wardrobe's over here as well. So all Erin really has got is her dressing table, but new additions to the office. I've got my Paquetta shirt on the wall in here, which personally signed to Brandon Common You Owns from Paquetta. Unreal, mate. And then over here, I've still got my Noble, Lanzini and Rice. I know he doesn't play for us anymore, but you know. And then this is my new obsession. So for Christmas, I got a vinyl player and I've got a session now with collecting vinyls and I got 5 vinyl frames to put on the wall. So I've got Post Malone, Drake, 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 Post Malone. This one, it goes so hard. Look at that. That is unreal. And then the beauty of it is lift up pull it forward and you can access it. Mate, these are so sick. If any of you like vinyls, you need these. Do you know what? I'll link them down below. I just love chilling up here, like whether I'm editing, playing on the games, on my computer, with a bit of vinyl in the background. It's just so sick. Bosh, but obviously I can't play them because copyright, so yeah, I'm just gonna chill, tidy this room up a little bit because it's a bit of a state. But yeah, I just wanted to show you my new vinyl setup and my new frame on the wall for Paquetta. Right, everybody, Rome is on his little bouncer, but I'm gonna try and talk over it because there is music on. I'll pause it for 2 seconds, but he's just on his bouncer with his little sensory, which he loves. Although I don't know how he's gonna tolerate being in this chair. He's still a bit clingy from his jabs, bless him. He just wants his mum and dad. Erin is looking at holidays again. We're gonna book one, aren't we?
Yeah, we are.
Bosh. I'm also just going to say, Erin's been and got her nails done. I'd have to come upstairs and I had the baby, so I can be bothered to go upstairs and get it. And then the clothes that I was wearing, I had to change because it had sick down it. So now I'm just wearing a black hoodie. Hi. Hi, Romy boy. Romy boy. Oh, he loves his sensory. Right, hello, mate. Hello. You're such a good boy. Right, guys, I'm gonna put some music on. The struggles of the copyright. But this is what we're listening to. Wait for it, there we go. Time to sort out this kitchen because the sink is filled up. This is clean, so this can come out and then that stuff can go in. I need to wash up the three, I've got three of these newbies, they're like rapid calls. Need to clean them out and then sterilize them. And I need to clean the bottles because I don't think we've got any new ones. I love doing this every day. I'm not even joking, I actually quite like doing this. Freshens my mind up a little bit. So let's get to work, we'll time lapse.
Having my nails done now, and I just got a French tip. I actually have biab now, and they've grown really long. But I'm just making some dinner, just making spaghetti bolognese. When I say spaghetti, I'm actually doing pasta, so I just prefer pasta. Just find it much easier to cook, like, and to eat, basically. So I just whacked some garlic bread in the oven as well. Yeah, love making spag bol. It's so super easy. And if there's any leftovers, then Brandon can have it for lunch tomorrow. So yeah, I'll show you guys the finished. Ow! I just spat me. It really hurt. I'll show you guys the finished result. And then. Yeah, Brandon's just feeding Rhyme. That's about it. That's the time. 8 o'clock. Quite late for dinner, actually. The day has just completely run away with us. But yeah, I've got the Traitors to watch at 9, which is my favourite time of the day.
We've just been sat here for ages, haven't we, Rhyme? We've just been listening to some music. And obviously, I can't film music because copyright. Been sat here watching the Traitors, Dragon's Den. One day, we're going to look back at this and you're going to be really big. And then you're going to be like, oh my God, how is I so small? What is the time? The time right now is 11:35 p.m. So I think, to be honest, for the sake of my eyeballs, I'm gonna go to sleep soon. Oh, I can't wait to sleep. I actually can't wait. You can probably tell in my eyes still hurting a little bit today, but yeah. So yeah, it's been a pretty real day, to be fair. I mean, we've had no naps, which is quite real because we don't really nap that often, although we probably should do. But specifically because of these jabs he's had, he's been a lot more, he's just been really clingy to us, bless him. But he's a baby at the end of the day and he just wants more love because he's feeling a bit sorry for himself. So, oh yeah, we booked the holiday. We're going to
Ibiza.
Ibiza, London to Ibiza. Dance the night away. Obviously, we're going to a family hotel. We're going to the place that we went in 2018, which is very, very exciting. So, guys, I mean, it's literally been a whole day. 24 hours. Finito. Oh, Romy. Are we going to have a good night's sleep tonight? Eh, please? Hey, the other day, we caught your first smile on camera. We caught your first smile. You have been awake quite a lot today, so hopefully you sleep tonight. Do you think you're going to sleep? Yes, say yes, go yes.
Probably do a feed soon as well, and then we're gonna go to bed. So guys, I'm gonna love and leave you all. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Follow all the socials for when you're not on YouTube so you can keep up to date with everything we do. Instagram, TikTok, Snapchat, Twitter, everything. And we're gonna love and leave you all. Subscribe to the channel, we're nearly at 500,000 as well. See you next week, peace.